Hi class, it's Bill Berry with a follow-up to the Chapter 5 video. There was one video that gave you a wee introduction to functions. There was another video that did the gentle introduction with real-world examples. But what I think we're lacking here is an example that is more full, that really has you think through all of the calls and the data a little more specifically. So I'm going to make this video to try to help put those pieces together and hopefully make it possible and easier for you to move forward with functions. So the example that we're going to do is the following. We're going to do a start to finish project, and this is going to be a bakery project. So what we want to do is we want to let the user enter the number of pies and cakes. We're not going to differentiate these and make them fancy. It's just pies and cakes. We want the program to calculate the price for the pies, which is going to be $17.99 a pie, and the cakes, which is going to be $24.99 a cake. And then it's going to calculate the tax, and it's going to calculate the total, and it's going to display a nice order like you see at the right. So it's going to have a title and nicely aligned items and counts and prices, and everything's going to look wonderful just like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to start building this from scratch, and we're going to I'll make a couple of videos if necessary, at least one to do the calculation part and probably a separate one to do the display stuff and formatting, because there's a lot of little fun details in there. So the next thing, let's look at the call hierarchy. We might imagine something like the following, where we have a main program and then it calls input order data so that the user can fill in the stuff, and then it calls price order, which will calculate all the pricing, which will involve including pricing the pie portion, cake portion, tax, and the total, and then last but not least it will call display summary. And so that is a reasonable call hierarchy. Now, we're going to find out later that there's some things we don't like about this, but let's just say we start with this and that we'll hold ourselves to this call hierarchy. Now, one of the things to realize is that when we come up with this, remember that the order in which these things are going to execute is going to be exactly as follows. Main is going to call input order data. Input order data is going to do its thing, and then control passes back to main. You don't have to do anything, but when this ends, it'll automatically, control will come back to main. Main will then call price the order. Price order will then call price the pies, and that will come back, and then it'll call price the cakes, and then control returns to price order, and then call calculate tax, and then control comes back here, and then it calls calculate total, control comes back here. Once price order is done, control goes back to main, and main calls display summary, it does its work, and then control comes back to main, which will then end. It's important to understand that that's the order that is implied here, and if you have any trouble with that, stop and think, but it's important that we understand that that is exactly how things are called. Now, there's going to be some data that's flowing around here. So that's the next thing to do, but the first thing is to get the hierarchy right. Now, let's start thinking about the data a little bit. I'll put some markings here, but one of the really good ways to do that is you take this call hierarchy and you annotate it. So get a pencil and paper, print this out, and get a pencil, and start writing down the following. What does each function, what does each little box here need in order to do its work? And when it is done, what does it have? What has it created? What work does it have that it needs to give back to the program that called it? And then the calling program gets that and it can move forward with it. So whatever its output is that is useful that might be needed elsewhere, it has to hand that back. So let's look briefly at what each of these does in terms of what it needs and what it passes back. So first, what does main have that input order data needs? Or another way to think of it is, what does input order data need in order to do its work? And the answer is really nothing. As long as main says, hey, go do your stuff, input order data can go start asking the user questions. So there's really no data that flows from here to here to get things started. But when input order data is done, what does it have that main needs, or that some other piece over here is going to need as a result of the work? Well, that's important. It's going to need the count of pies and the count of cakes, because if it doesn't pass it back to main, then the data is dead, right? It doesn't go anywhere, and then how are we going to price it? How are we going to display it, etc.? So the flow from main to input order data is the following. Nothing goes down. The pie count and the cake count are going to come back. then what goes from main to price order. Now, we have to think about this in terms of what price order needs to do its work, or what any of its children are going to need, because the only way they can get it is through price order. This little chain of command here, the hierarchy, is very strict. Main can't give things directly to here. So we have to think about this. Well, input order data gave us a k count and a pi count. Those things are going to be necessary for price order to have in hand, because it's going to have to pass some of that down in order to do this pricing. So the flow of data is main has to pass it the count of cakes and the count of pies. Then what does this price pies need in order to calculate the price of the pies? Well, it needs the count of the pies. So it needs to pass down the count of the pies, and what does it give back when it's done? The price of the pies, because that's going to be needed elsewhere. Same thing here, we need to pass down the quantity, the count of cakes, and then we need to pass back the total price of the cakes. What do we have to pass to calculate tax in order for it to do its work? Well, we need a subtotal, right? How's it going to calculate tax if it doesn't know what the subtotal is? So we need to pass down a subtotal to here, and it needs to pass back the tax. And then to calculate total, we better pass over the subtotal and the tax, and it's going to calculate the total and pass that back. And then here's the big one. What does this know that's needed either by main or the one remaining child that needs to do some work? Well, basically everything that we've accumulated along the way is all going to be used in display summary, because it displays the counts, the prices, the subtotal, the tax, and the total. So all of that must flow back from price order to main, and from main then to display summary. Now, please rewind the video if that's not something that you understand. Go listen to that again and make sure that you understand the hierarchy and also then how that data flows. If you annotate that all with arrows, you'll probably come up with a better solution, but this is what it looked like once I had done it with little straight arrows. You can draw curvier ones with a pencil. But that is the flow of the data through the program. And it's important for us to do this because when we write our functions, we're going to have now a very clear idea, because everything where there is a down arrow, that's going to be a parameter that needs to be passed to a function. And where there is an up arrow with some stuff, that is some return data that needs to come back from the function and be consumed by or stored by the program of the function above it in order to continue to do the work. So from this, we actually have a great way to start, and we can actually start writing a skeleton of the program just based on what we have here. So our next step is we understand the parameters, we understand the return values a little bit, so now we can write a skeleton program and start filling things in. So let's do that real quick. I'm going to move this out of the way, and then I'm going to, I'll bring the hierarchy back as soon as we need it for any purpose. So the first thing that I know I can do is I can start my main program. I can say define main, and I know from what we've seen here, I'm going to call input order data. So I know I'm going to say input order data. Now, we're going to fill in a lot later, but you understand the idea. And then we know it's going to call next price order. And then we know it needs to call display summary. So we know that that's what main looks like. Now, we have more to flesh out, but let's just write in the calls, and then we'll be cleverer later. We also know what these functions are going to be. We're going to define a function called input order data, and it's going to be whatever that is. And we're going to make another one that's called price the order, and another one called def display summary. So we know that's going to be there, and then we know under price order we have a few more. Let me fill those in. So now we've got all our call hierarchy all implemented here. Now, again, we haven't gotten the flow of data figured out completely. Well, and I guess we can do the obvious too down here. We can call main, right? We know that's going to be at the bottom. So that's a great way to start. And the program actually will compile and it'll run. It doesn't do anything yet because we don't have any code that does anything of consequence. But if we put a little print statement here that says, I am in input order data, that shouldn't be order, we would actually see that the thing works, right? That it calls these things, and we could prove that the hierarchy works by putting little print statements in there. We also know that price order, we already said, is going to somewhere call price pies, and it's going to call price cakes, and it's going to call calculate tax, and calc total, right? So our call hierarchy is completely fleshed out. We can save it, we can run it, and it comes back and says, okay, indentation block, right? We don't have any code in here, so it's not exactly happy with us, but it actually is, you know, it is in good shape at the moment. Okay, so the next thing that we can do is to start figuring out, based on the little data flow that we have here, what things are parameters and what things are returns. So notice here that we had nothing coming down from main to input order data. Therefore, this blank is going to stay, right? There is no parameter. No parameters need to be passed into it. But when it's done, it needs to pass back the item counts. So we need to say somewhere blah blah blah, right? Blah blah blah. We're going to say return, and we're going to pass back the counts. So it's going to be something like pass back pie count and cake count. All right? So do you see how we translated that, right? Nothing comes down, item counts go back, nothing in the parameters, but the return is those two pieces of data. And then let's go to the next one. Main, passing things to price order. We said the item counts need to come down. So for price order, we're going to have pie count and cake count. Now, please be aware that these names do not have to match. Each function can have its own little interpretation of what that data is. So if here I said num pies and num cakes, it wouldn't be any problem as long as I am consistent within this function. So don't worry about the fact that sometimes you'll see them looking one way and some another. I'm going to purposefully do some of these to show you that it doesn't matter as long as the function receives it. Think of it as a local variable that this is defining that just happens to get filled in when it gets called. So price order is going to get those two, and then we know at the very end price order needs to return a whole bunch of stuff, right? So blah blah blah, and then price order needs to return a whole bunch of things. The pie total, the cake total, the subtotal, tax total. Right? It needs to return all of that stuff because main needs to know it. Now, it already knows, it's already going to know the pie count and the cake count. We'll come to that in just a second. So we can continue that way. It's the same thing here. When we go to price the pies, we need to have the pie count. And then what do we need to return? We do some stuff, and then we need to return the pie price, or whatever you're going to say, pie total. Same thing with cakes. We know we need to blah blah blah. Somewhere we need to pass it in the cake count, and then we need to pass back the cake total dollars, or whatever you want to call that. Calculate tax, we said we need to pass in the subtotal, and then blah blah blah, we need to return the tax that is calculated. The total, we need to pass in the tax and the subtotal. And then we need to blah 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 return the total. Right? Does that make sense? Now this is just a placeholder. More code goes here. I'm just putting comments here. Display summary, remember, from the diagram, doesn't need to pass anything back. It has nothing. Once it's displayed all of its work, it really has nothing to pass back to main because there's nothing left to do. There's nothing main can do except just end. So it doesn't have to pass anything back at all. So display summary needs to be passed a whole bunch of stuff, right? The number of pies, the number of cakes, the pie price or total, the cake price, not the individual, right? So cake price, total pie price, total cake price, the subtotal, the tax, and the total. Again, don't worry about the fact that I called this num cakes and up here I called it cake count, or that I called this cake price, or and I've called it pie, you know, cake total or something. Like, don't freak out about that. As long as you are consistent within this function, that's all that makes a difference, right? These are local variables that are filled in when this is called. So we don't have to be too overly concerned that we name things exactly the same. We may choose to, we may not, and that is really kind of okay. All right, so good stuff. We have a start. Now, the only other thing we haven't done is we haven't taken anything back. So, for instance, when input order data returns the pie count and the cake count, we need to store it in main or else we're going to discard it. So if we just call it this way, we're going to throw away that data because we've called the thing, it's tried to pass us something back, and we've just said, meh, We don't seem to care, right? We're not storing it. So we need to have a variable like something like number of pies and number of cakes equal to, and then we call the function. The function's going to return two things. Those two things are going to get stored. We better do the right order, right? It returns first the pies and then the cakes, first the pies and then the cakes. Now, be aware that Python is very odd in this sense that you can put these two variables with a comma and then call something and return two pieces of data. That is unusual in the programming world, but Python lets you do it, so we might as well take advantage of it. Same thing with price order. We know that it calculates some useful stuff, so we need to make sure that we store the pie price, the cake price, the order subtotal. Did I spell that right? Total, the order tax, and the order total, and then we call price order. And because we said we need to pass in the pie count and the cake count, which up here are called numpies and numcakes, I need to put in numpies and numcakes. We need to pass it that data. Okay, and then display summary. We need to pass it the things that it needs. Remember down here we came up with these. Right? So we need to make sure we pass all of that stuff in. Up here, those happen to be called number of pies, number of cakes, pie price, cake price, and etc. Again, you notice here I've been extremely consistent with my naming within one function. Right, so here I call it numpies, here I pass numpies, here I get back order subtotal, here I call it order subtotal. This is all consistent. That I named it differently down there does not concern us. Again, each function is independent, it's standalone, so don't freak out about that. So let's see if there's anywhere else that we need to do things. Well, when we call price pies, it returns a pie total, so we better store that. Right? We better bring these things back, cake total. And again, anything that is passed back that is useful, when price cakes pass us back the cake total, we better store it because we need to use it somewhere. Calculate tax, we better actually save the tax because we're going to need it somewhere. And what do we pass it? Well, we pass it the subtotal. Now we have some work to do in between here. We haven't calculated it yet. And then we better call total and save the results of calc total, and we better pass it subtotal and tax. Right? And then really the only piece that's left here is we need to calculate the subtotal, which actually isn't very exciting, right? It's the pie total plus the cake total. Right? That's one little calculation that we needed to do. So really this one's kind of complete, right? But that's how you start translating. Once you understand the hierarchy and you understand the flow of data through the program, you can start doing exactly what we've done, and that is put in the parameters, put in the returns, put in where you need to store data that comes back from those calls, and then we can start fleshing out the thing in just a second. So I'm going to stop the video here because we've got to, you know, getting along here. So let's stop the video here and then we'll start fleshing out these a little bit more.